Yeah, hi. I thought it'd be useful to do a quick video on fitting the infamous Y piece. Basically, it's part of the heat ducting that takes heat from the heat exchangers on the engine all the way through some pipework up the front. So there's this kind of Y piece that fits through the cross member and over the torsion bar. And you can't fit it in one piece unless you've got the floor out. So really, I should have done it with the floor in, but I didn't think. The piece comes in one section, but it's actually made of three bits spot welds together, so I drilled out, ground away the spot welds. So I've got three bits. This is the first bit I've managed to get in, and you had to slightly crush the end of it to get it through, only by like 2 mil or so. I can always expand it again if I need to. I'll get that piece in. And then we've got the other pieces here. So I've cut little notches on it slightly just to give me a bit of compression on it, to make it a bit easier to fit. And I've labelled these because I'm a bit of a moron, keep getting it wrong. And the only way to do it is through this middle section here, which is slightly lower than the rest of the torsion bar, and get it through. And the other thing I've had to do is chop out the spot welds holding the clutch cable guide tube onto this, otherwise you can't get both pieces in, which is a bit of movement. So this piece goes at the bottom. For some reason this one is longer than the other, can't quite work out why. But yeah. Just about to get that piece in. Like that. And then second piece. Again, I have to move the clutch cable out of the way. Like that. And then the secret to the whole operation is these little guys. So before I put it in there, I've put it all together and drilled holes for my little Glico clips that you kind of put through both holes and hold it together. So I'm going to pause it now because it's going to take me a couple of minutes to get it in. Last night I took about 10 minutes to get the clips in properly. And then I'll show you, once I have the three bits in, I kind of use Glico clips on one of them to hold that in place. And then got the second one because I found that if you try and do it without, you can't get this first one in without, well, you can't get the second one in without the first one falling out. So yeah, it's in there now. Just need to put some welds around. I'll just tack it back on where I've cut it, and then join it to the cross member in the floor. And next time, I'll put it in before I take the floor out. And I'll just chop it into three bits. There you go. It can be done.